Hello there, I am ASCP Hunter, real estate broker for Su Casa, Su Castillo. In today's segment under new agents, we're going to be talking about how it is to be an agent, not only locally, but an agent is not the same in New York as an agent is in California, and or as a matter of fact, around the world. And that's what we're going to be talking about today. How is different for each market? Independently of this, to begin with, each property itself, it is unique to itself. Add to that, the region of the country you are at. An agent who operates in New York City is restricted to many regulations because the city is older. And not only to, it could be regulations just to the building itself, to a neighborhood specific, especially historic places, regulations of operations. So New York real estate agents will have to have a set of knowledge specific to New York, into that specific neighborhood, that specific building. It's very knowledge specific. As an agent that would operate in California and sell houses, beach houses in Malibu, is unique to that area, or Miami in itself, Miami, Florida, or New Jersey, or San Diego. So each region, especially regions in the country, such as big cities, those are the ones that they require unique knowledge of the market. That translates into the world, wherever part of the world you operate. Because the older the country, the way the properties transfer is could be different and it's unique, the history, historic properties, or regulations within the property. So that is why agents take. It's not that kind of industry where, you know, if you are a doctor, you specialize in certain medicine, you could go to another country and operate or another state and operate the same way. With real estate, you need a moment to get to know your area where you live and know the regulations, the way the market works, because it's unique to itself. Even though we could be licensed, obtain our license somewhere else, another state, it takes a moment to learn the rules and regulations of that state or city you want to sell. Now, the most common ones, you know, when you think about real estate agents is homes that are single homes and planned communities where everything is homogeneous and very similar. And throughout the country, there's a lot of locations like that. And it's true. Many of the majority of real estate agents work in this scenario, which is very similar. It's similar type of home, similar type of demographics, a lot of similarities that they don't have to have all these restrictions. So basically what I'm getting at is the closer you are to sophisticated cities, the more sophisticated agent you have to be because you have to know more. I hope this has helped you because it will help you understand and not get frustrated that you need to learn these things to better function as an agent and that it takes a moment. And that's why agents who are born in an area sometimes do really well because they know the history of the place like nobody else. So local agents, and there are many I have known, for example, in San Francisco, in the Bay Area, if they're born and raised there, they know who lived there, who lived there, what has transpired, the laws that have changed through time, and they are able to understand a lot and convey that information to their clients. Same thing as New York, or same thing as people from New Jersey, or people who live in Malibu. It's same thing in Texas, if they have local people. But like I say, in Texas it's a little different because we have so much land. And things are could be the same for miles and miles, okay? And the regulations are not so heavy like historic towns. Anytime that you deal with historic buildings, historic areas, or older cities. I hope this has helped you. Till next time.